Hi, good morning. This is Basha. We are going to discuss about analytical geometry. In previous class, we derive the formula for internal and externally dividing the point. Now, in CRT3, midpoint. What is a midpoint? By using the section formula, which is internally dividing. For example, AB is a line segment where P is a interior to AB, then P dividing in the ratio M is to N, where A x1 y1 and B x2 y2. Then the point of which dividing AB in the ratio M is to N is known as P x comma y is equal to MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N, comma M by 2 plus N by 1 by M plus N, which is known as internally dividing the AB line segment. In this case, where M is equal to N, M is equal to N means we will get the ratio 1 is to N, whatever it may be, 4 is to 4 also, by cancelling it, we will get 1 is to 1. By substituting M1 N values in this equation, M1 N1, we will get X1 plus X2 by 1 plus 1, 2, comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2, which is known as a midpoint of AB line segment by using section formula. Similarly, we can find the point of trisection. Point of trisection. What is mean by trisection? Observe, AB is a line segment where the points P and Q dividing the AB into three equal parts, which are known as, for example, I am taking 1, 1, 1, which are equal. Let us AP dividing AP and BP. P dividing AB in the ratio 1 is to 2. Similarly, Q dividing AB line segment in the ratio 2 is to 1. By using the section formula, instead of M and N, once we will substitute 1 is to 2 and again we will substitute 2 is to 1, internally dividing. Then the next one is making into 4 equal parts. 4 equal parts, same. AB is a line segment where PQR, which are on the line segment AB, then which are dividing the AB line segment into 4 equal parts, means 1, 1, 1, 1. Then P divides AB internally in the ratio 1 is to 3. P divides in the ratio 1 is to 3. Then Q, Q is the midpoint of AB on the AB line segment. So Q divides AB in the ratio 2 is to 2 or which is known as 1 is to 1. Then R divides AB line segment in the ratio 3 is to 1. Means here A, P, Q, R, B are collinear points in each and every case. In these three cases, all points are collinear which lies on the same line segment. Then the next one is harmonic conjugate. Which are called harmonic conjugate? For example, AB is a line segment in which P and Q are any two points. P is interior to AB and Q is exterior to AB. Means AP, BQ are collinear. The ratio which P divides internally in the AB line segment and also Q divides AB externally in the same ratio which divides, then P and Q are harmonically conjugate points with respect to AB. Means for example, P dividing AB in the ratio L is to M, then Q dividing AB externally in the ratio minus L is to M. The ratio is same, but one is internally, one is externally. The sign is different. Means the points which are dividing internally and externally in the same ratio of a line segment is called harmonic conjugate. Harmonic conjugate. Here P and Q are points of harmonic conjugate. Then with respect to AB, P and Q are harmonic conjugate points. With respect to PQ, A and B are harmonic conjugate points. Let us, if P dividing AB in the ratio L is to M, then Q dividing AB externally in the ratio minus L is to M, then A and B dividing in the ratio L plus M is to L minus M. Then the next one is centroid. What is a centroid? Centroid means in triangle ABC, the point of intersection of medians. What is a median? Median means a line segment which is drawn from vertex to midpoint of a opposite side is known as a median. In each and every triangle, we can draw three medians. Observe, BC midpoint D, AC midpoint E, AB midpoint F. D, E, F are the midpoints of three sides of a triangle. Their intersection, which is known as G, means centroid. Intersection of medians in a triangle is known as a centroid. It is denoted with a capital G. Capital G. Observe here, let us take A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 and C x3 y3, which are the vertices of a triangle. Then the centroid formula is G is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. By using this condition, we will find the centroid G, which divides the each median. G divides every median in the ratio 2:1. 2:1 means 2:1. 2:1. And by using these conditions, we will find, if we know A, comma B, comma G, then we will find the third vertex of the given triangle. Means, for example, we know AB, x1, y1, x2, y2. Then the centroid G, I am taking x, comma y, or alpha, comma beta, anyway. So, if we know A, B, C, then the vertex C is given by 3x minus x1 minus x2, comma 3y minus y1 minus y2, which is known as a third vertex of the triangle ABC. We have another condition. If centroid of triangle ABC is equal to centroid of triangle DEF, means ABC. ABC centroid, also the centroid for the triangle which is joining the midpoints of the three sides of triangle ABC. Both the centroids will get the same value. And the next condition is, if G is the centroid of the triangle, then we will get a condition which is in the form of AB square plus BC square plus AC square is equal to 3 into GA square plus GB square plus GC square, which is a condition from, if we know three sides and the centroid value, three vertices and the centroid value. And then we have another condition. In a parallelogram,